Good morning, movers. Welcome back to Move Daily Fitness. I'm Tracy Steen. This beginner workout, we're focusing all on your upper body. All right, back, chest, biceps, triceps, and shoulders is what we're gonna hit today. And your format will be 40 seconds of work with 15 seconds in between. We'll hit everything for 2 rounds. All right, grab a variety of dumbbells for the workout. I'll also use my bench, but you don't need one. You can also use the floor or a Swiss ball if you'd like. I'll start you with a warm up and we'll end with the cool down. All right, are you ready to move daily? Let's do it. Very good. I'm gonna put strength on my watch today and let's warm things up here. Some front and back bends to start. Just warm up that lower back and your glutes and hamstrings a little. One more here. Good. Just a nice twist high knee right here. More. All right, single side circle, big stretch back. And reverse directions. Switch sides. Reverse directions. Let's take it feet shoulder width apart. Squat it here and reach those arms overhead. Last one here. Take it wide and open in the chest. Last one here. Stay wide, we'll touch our toes and reach that other arm up behind you. If you can't touch your toes, just reach to touch your knee, that's fine. Let's put our hands together, elbows together, press to the ceiling and down for 10. And reach across, tap here. Up and over. And we'll finish with a torso turn right here. Very good. All right, 2 rounds of everything. There's the first circuit. I'm gonna start on my bench, but again, you can start on the floor, and there's the weights that I'm using for this circuit. All right, I'm gonna start with that one arm row. Maybe a 10 pound dumbbell to start. Nice flat back. I'll call halfway and we'll switch arms. If you don't have a bench, prop yourself up like this. And we pull. I want you to think about retracting the shoulder blade at the top of the pull. One more here, and switch your side. All right, have a seat. You could also do the standing if you didn't grab a seat, that's fine. Nice and tall, we're gonna do a front raise right out to the front. You can hold the dumbbell this way as well. I'm holding a 10, and we lift and down. Now, this is an easy one to round through the shoulder, so I want you to stick your chest out each time the dumbbell comes to the bottom. Up, stick your chest here. All right, grabbing really light weights. Okay, we're gonna just grab twos here. I'm gonna take it wide. Elbows are gonna come in and then out. If you don't want to add the plie, you're just gonna stand right. Here we go, low and out to the side. Little plie, side bicep serve, press. Again, if you want to just keep this upper body only, if you did legs yesterday, you're right here. Just adding a little legs to kick up the heart rate a bit. To the top again, back to your one arm row. This is your opportunity to switch weights if you need to. Again, I'll call half. Prop yourself up here if you don't have that bench. And row, we lift, good. Switch sides. And have a seat for that front raise. Or stand. Nice and tall. All right, shoulders back and low, away from the ears. Bring the dumbbell to 90 degrees. And up for that plie bicep serve. Just holding those twos. Elbows come in and then press out to the side. Drop it low and press right there. Okay, I'm gonna grab my other 10 and head to the bench, or you can head to the floor. Wide, narrow press for chest. You're gonna start wide, and then you're gonna turn and face at the top. Flat back, down, and turn and flex. So you can squeeze your chest at the top there. Good. Now I don't want you to dip your elbows below 90 degrees if you are on a bench. If you're on the floor, it's kind of perfect because you can go ahead and tap the floor with your elbows. You're never gonna go below 90 on the floor. But on the bench, just be mindful of that. All right, I'm gonna use the 10s for my triceps, but we'll do a lion tricep press to overhead extension. Palms are facing this time. Press to the ceiling, bend at the elbow, and return. Here we go. Press it up, back of the elbow, up and down. Press, back, up, and down. Come to standing. We are gonna do a little tricep kick out here with our light weights again. It'll kick the heart rate up a little bit. Elbows are wide. We'll step behind and kick just like that. Nice and tall. We kick. Let's go. Try to keep your elbows up, but don't shrug your shoulders. Very good. All right, round two. Back to the wide narrow press. I'll stick with 10s here. And then right into that tricep extension. Starting wide, press and flex. Very good. I'll go right into that tricep extension. Lighten if you need. Again, palms are facing. We'll come down, press it up, tricep overhead, and then return. Let's drop and down. Up, bend at the elbow, back up and down. Okay, set those down and back for that little cardio kick out. Holding light weights, just the twos for me. Step behind, elbows out, and we kick right here. Thank you. I'm gonna bring my lighter weights over from some seated lateral raises. Twos, threes, fives, maybe. You're gonna sit nice and tall. Okay, and we're popping it out to 90 degrees on the side. So we pop, stick your chest out. Set those down. We're gonna go into a single side shoulder press or military press, okay? I'm nice and tall here, pressing overhead. I'll call halfway, we'll switch. Maybe a 3, 5, 8, somewhere in that range. So we press 90 degrees, good. Stay tall. One more here, switch your side and press. What you don't want to do is lean over somehow to press that up. Keep your body, your torso totally still, just that shoulder's working. And set that down. Grabbing the light weights again, coming to standing. Wide plie again. We're gonna come low and over. All right, just nice reach over. I'll call half. We'll switch down and reach. Good. Again, if you want to eliminate the plie, you're just here with that arm movement. Last one here. Switch sides. Back to your lateral raise. Holding those lighter weights. Twos, threes, fives, or no weight is good too if you need. And pop. Up to 90 on the armpit there. And grabbing a heavier weight for my shoulder press. Whatever works for you. 3, 5, 8, 10. All right, I'll call half. And press. Last one there, switch your side and press. And let's go into that overhead reach with our light weights. Or no weights. All right, holding one here. And we sweep low and over. last one here. Switch your side. We're gonna take a 30-second water break after this. If you don't need the rest, you can keep this one going until I'm back on the screen. I'm gonna stick with that 10-pound dumbbell in a bent over wide row. So hinging forward, we're gonna pull it out to the side and down. You can prop yourself up for support if you'd like. Flat back, and we pull to the side and down. I'll call half. One more here, and switch your side, flat back, and pull. We're bent over like this because we want to hit those rear delts, the back shoulder muscle. Okay, a little bit of your back middle muscle called your rhomboid, a little bit of the trap as well. I'm gonna grab eights for my bicep curl. All right. Palms are up, we're gonna curl all the way up to the top, all the way down to the bottom, knees are soft. And we curl up, down, down. One, two, one, two. Try not to lean forward on the down, stay tall. Those down. I'll grab those light weights again for my leg kickback and tricep kickback. I'll call half. We'll switch legs, but we're gonna do a little kickback and a little leg glute kickback. So we lift and lift. So you're slightly hinged forward at the waist. Elbows are in by your sides. Nice little kickback. One more here. Now switch your leg and kick. All right, let's go back to the top with your bent over wide row. I'm gonna stick with a 10-pound dumbbell. Go lighter if you'd like. All right, flatten your back. Pull it out to the side. And we pull. And up. One more here. All right, switch. And I'm grabbing those lighter weights for my bicep curl. Again, knees are soft, core is engaged so that you don't round forward. Shoulders back, elbows in, and we curl. All the way up, all the way down, full range of motion here. and into that kickback. Glute and tricep kickback. This is challenging for that stationary leg, isn't it? You feel that in the glute a little bit. Hinge forward, core engaged, and we kick and kick. I'll call half. All right, switch legs. All right, shake that out. You got one more circuit. I'm gonna just grab those 5-pound dumbbells here. We're gonna move to a front raise. So palms start wide. We're gonna come together at the top, stick the chest out, and then back down. Shoulders back, knees are soft. And you're here and slow. Great. Moving to biceps again. I'm gonna grab, I think, my 10s here for a pinwheel curl. Feel free to go lighter though. You're gonna cross the body, your torso stays still, flex at the top. And we flex, so I want your palm to come up towards your chin. It kind of faces the ceiling, up. Great, torso doesn't turn. Right, setting those down, grabbing the lightweights again. I'm gonna butt kick single leg extension here. Nice little tricep, little shoulder, and we'll get a little glute and hamstring in as well. All right, you're here, one, alternate, that's it. You don't wanna do the lower body, you're here. Of course, you can do this without the weight as well. I've just got the 2 pounds. Back to the top with your front raise, palms face the ceiling. All right, nice wide stance on the arms there. Out to the side and bring them close together at the top. So you're here, don't swing at the bottom. Moving to the biceps. Okay, I'll stick with 10 pounds here, crossing the body, flexing at the top, starting with knees are soft. Let's flex right here. Good. Okay, finishing off with that butt kick extension. Holding light weights here again at the shoulder, alternating butt kick and extension. Let's work, last one here. Last 10 seconds, stay with me. Almost there, folks. In 3, 2, 1, and done. You move daily in your upper body beginner workout. Awesome work. Thanks for joining. Enjoy for a stretch if you can. All right, let's stretch things out here. I'm gonna go on a wall, open up in the chest. Oh, it's always a good stretch. It's always a good time. Lengthening through that pec muscle there. Mine is always tight, so I often do this throughout the day. Do you ever stop in between a door frame and open your chest up? Switch sides here. You should. It's a good one. Totally a good one. All right, good work. I'm trying to build lean muscle in the upper body. Tomorrow I might recommend something for lower body, or you could do straight cardio or something with cardio and abs. We didn't hit abs today, even though they're sort of part of the upper body, they're also part of the lower body. Round through the back here, right? Your whole abdominal wall is connected to the legs. So I didn't throw that in today, but you can certainly throw that in tomorrow. I think that would be fine. Yeah, and some of those little lighter weight actions did get the heart rate up, so that was great as well. Let's hinge forward at the waist. I want you to reach up and push your thumb to the ceiling here. You can roll the wrist around. Good. How's everyone doing in terms of their wellness and nutrition? We've got the fitness over here. For a lot of people, that seems to be the easiest of the three. What about you? Is it the easiest of the three? And it seems like a lot of people really struggle with nutrition, and then a lot of people put wellness on the back burner. That's what it seems like. In my years of working with people, it seems to be the common denominator. Let's go for triceps here. And my advice there is always be thinking of dripping water on the stone hollows it out, not through force, right? Not through something grandiose, not through something really restrictive, but through persistence. It's the dripping water. It's the little micro processes that add up over time, throughout the day, throughout the week, throughout the month, throughout the year, that help shift the trajectory of our ship toward optimizing health. And that is the key. So sometimes I think we bite off more than we can chew and we start very grandiose, and that often just stalls us because we can only do X for so long and then we lose motivation. But if you think of this as arms back, thumbs down, a lifestyle habit that people like us do things like this forever and ever and ever, then you don't start and stop. You might have off days where you're not as, you know, linked in, but you don't start and stop. You just keep going no matter what. And that's what I hope for you. That's what I hope for myself as well. Hey, thanks for joining. Now go move daily in your wellness and nutrition, and I'll see you in the next workout.